Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh. We're blessed to be gathered together reflecting on the coming of 7th Guru Sahib, Sri Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji. Their father was Baba Gurditta Ji, who was the Sahibjade, one of the sons of Miri Piri De Malik, Sahib Sri Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji, our 6th Guru. So Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji was the grandson of Sri Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji. Their mata was Mata Nihal Kaur, and they came to this world at a place called Kirtpur, now known as Kirtpur Sahib, which is to the east of Punjab near Sri Anandpur Sahib. Sri Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji at that time was at Amritsar Sahib, where Harmandir Sahib is and Takht Sri Akal Takht Sahib is. So Sri Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji came to this world around the age of 8 years. They became the Guru of the Sikhs, and they spent just over 22 years on the Gurgaddi. And their time on this earth was around 30 to 31 years. If we look in Sri Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji's life, we can take three teachings away. There are many blessings that they gave the Guru Sikhs, but as I reflected, I've taken three teachings away. The first teaching we can take is Hukam Manana, to respect, to listen, to believe and to follow the hukam of our Guru. Sri Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji never turned down a hukam from Sri Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji. Even when they were the Guru, they never changed any command that they were given previously by Sri Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji. Sri Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji, when they made Sri Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji the Guru, said that you must keep 2200 horseback warrior Gursikhs with you at all times. And they always did. They also said, even though you will have this army, you are never to have a battle with any Mughals. Anybody who tries to attack the Guru's house, the Guru Kar, they will always fall away en route. And this happened on three occasions. When the Mughals tried to attack, they would fall away en route. One such time, the general had a disease and he died, and then the rest of the army would fall away and not come. So they always followed that command. They never had any battle with the Mughals, but they always had the army, tayar par tayar. When they were younger, we know that they broke some petals, their chola hit some flowers, and the petals broke and fell on the floor. And Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji, when they saw this, asked, who broke these flowers? Who broke these petals? And Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji obviously admitted that it was their chola. Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji said that if you wear such a big chola, then you should be able to be responsible for it. They were given an ishara, a message, that soon Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji were going to become the Guru of the Sikhs. And it's going to be such a great responsibility, and they would have to follow Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji's hukam to be able to take and live through that responsibility. And they manned that hukam. From that time, they would always carry their chola in their arms so it wouldn't hit anything. So we can take these teachings of listening, believing, and following the hukam of our Guru, just as Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji did themselves, even though they are the seventh form of Waheguru on this earth. The second teaching we can take away, the respect they showed Gurbani, the adab and the satkar they showed Gurbani. One such time, when they were sat on their throne, on their Manji Sahib, a Nagar Kirtan was coming towards them. So Gursikhs were singing Kirtan coming towards them, and they quickly jumped off their throne, and as they jumped off their throne, they hurt their knee. And the Gursikh Sevadars around them said, why Guru Sahib Ji did you jump up so quickly? You've hurt your knee. And Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji says, don't you hear these Gursikhs singing Kirtan? This Kirtan is Turki Bani. It's the Bani of Waheguru. Further, they even excommunicated and turned their own son away. Sri Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji had two Sahibjade. The eldest was known as Ram Rai. The youngest, as we know, Sri Guru Har Krishan Sahib Ji Maharaj, the 8th Guru of the Sikhs. Aurangzeb, who was the Mughal Emperor at that time, wanted to hold court with Guru Sahib Ji. Guru Sahib Ji refused, but then they sent Ram Rai in their place. Ram Rai showed many miracles because they had all the blessings of Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji. But the advisors of Aurangzeb said that Sri Guru Granth Sahib Ji's Bani has Bani against the Islamic faith. Aurangzeb asked, and there was a pankti in Sri Asaji Diwar, the Kirtan we sing in the mornings, the Bani of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji, Mitti Musalman Ki. That's how that line starts. And Ram Rai Ji, because he wanted to keep impressing Aurangzeb, said that that doesn't say Musalman, it's meant to say Bayman, there's a mistake. And so he changed the Bani of Guru Nanak Dev Ji. When Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji heard of this, he said, whichever way Ram Rai is facing, he should continue walking. I don't want to even see his face again. And Ram Rai, their own Sahibjade, their own son, was excommunicated from the Gursikhi faith. So that even shows as a message to us, we should never disrespect Gurbani, we should never deface Gurbani, we should never change Gurbani. Whether that is that Bani is from Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji, or whether that Bani is from Sahib Sri Guru Gobind Singh Sahib Ji. Any Bani that our Guru has given us, we should never change, we should never disrespect, we should always show the utmost respect to Gurbani. So that's the second teaching we could say that we could take from their life on this earth, their teachings. The third I reflect on is Bhav Bhakti, the love and the recitation of Gurbani and Naam. Now, we know many Gursikhs do a lot of nitname at various times. The Gursikh nitname is five banis in the morning, Rehras and Kirtan Sohila evening and at night. But Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji, on top of that, just like the teachings of our Gurus are, is to do as much nitname and naam abhyas as possible. Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji, six times did Sava Lakh Sri Japji Sahib de paath. Sava Lakh is 125,000. If you do 100 Japji Sahibs a day, then it will take you around 3 to 4 years to complete 125,000 total Japji Sahibs. 100 Japji Sahibs, if you're doing one Japji Sahib around 10 minutes or 5 to 15 minutes, can take a long time. That's most of the day. Sri Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji did that six times at the time on this earth. And we sometimes question, why do we need to read Bani over and over again? But reading Gurbani over and over again is imbuing us in that Naam, in that oneness, breaking away our negative karam that we've collected over these life forms and joining us with Waheguru. So Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji did that six times. They didn't need to do that, as did their form, the embodiment of Waheguru on this earth, but they did that to show us. At the same time, they did 36,600,000 Mool Mantra Japs. Ik Oankar to Nanak Hosipi Sach. So imagine doing those as well as the Japji Sahib, as well as the other Nitname that they would have been commanded to do, as the Gursikhs used to do at that time. Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji, like I said, didn't need to do that. That was a teaching to us. So their time on this earth, they gave many blessings to many Gursikhs. We could be here forever and ever singing the praises of Sahib Sri Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji. We listen to them we remember them in the Ardas, Simrao Sri Har Rai. And by remembering Sri Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji, we get those same blessings that those Gursikhs did in those times. They gave us three teachings. If we reflect, in summary, to man the hukam of our Guru, to have adab satkar and respect, the utmost respect for Gurbani, and then to continue having that love and praying for Naam and Gurbani, and to do that abhyas so we can break free from the 8.4 million birth and death life cycle and become one with Waheguru ourselves. Let us hope and pray that Sahib Sri Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji blesses us so we can also live Sikhi. Deho Sajjan Asis Chidiyan Jehova Sahib Shumil Likha Kata Hina Shutiya Khen Khen Poolan Har Baksan Har Baksalai Nanak Paar Utar Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh.